Ready to start it? Back here, just again reviewing our last game there. Disappointing in our play. We got outplayed, outcoached there for sure. Didn't change anything in our approach as far as what we're doing practice-wise or whatever. Kind of stayed on our routine as far as time on task, number of plays, how we practice. I think we do a lot of things in a pretty good way. We've had some solid, strong performances, it's obvious, and we've had a couple that have not been as good. So, said back in preseason, we're looking for consistency. And again, I see some solid things, I think, in our routine. I think our players like what we're doing practice-wise, but you got to transfer it into the game. So, there's more than just practice now, what we're doing mentally and our respect to the game and the opponent and all that stuff. There's a lot more than just in practice time and game time that goes into the week. So, just asking our guys to kind of take a look at it. I know across the board, we didn't, again, change a lot, but from an effort standpoint, we go from, 89 offensive knockdowns 2 weeks ago to 33. So that's 56 less times. We had 21 missed tackles. I don't think we had 21 in three games. So just all of a sudden, now again, played a good opponent. We had a lot of respect for Maryland coming in, knew they were very, very good, and they played very, very well. And so, again, give those guys a bunch of credit. But just a little disappointed, kind of surprised, but we're going to keep working at it, pushing these guys. With some of the young guys playing, again, I think it takes just a little bit. I know previous coaches I've worked with would always say it takes just a little bit to be off. And when you get a little bit off, you can get exposed. And we were off Saturdays in a lot of ways, a little bit, and it really added up for us. So got to work to clean that up. Expect us to, again, to keep pushing for some consistency and more than anything, kind of have a winning spirit, and kind of do the things we need to kind of keep moving the right way for some good guys, good players. Our players of the game. Offensively, we didn't have anyone we recognized up front, perimeter, or in the backfield. So not a good performance from the offense across the board collectively. Defensively, we thought we had two really good performances. Thought Darius Latham played his best game to date. Needed him to keep coming along. Again, he's been here now, not quite two full years. Played some last year, not a lot. He's still in the rotation mix. The more he plays, hopefully the better he gets. But there's a lot of football for him in front of him, so he's got a long way to go. I mean, he could be so much better, and it's good to see him gaining on it. Good game by Darius. Timmy Bennett, by far his best game. And more importantly, I just think from the last week, he's been significantly, to me, a little bit like the Tim Bennett I saw last year. There's just been a lot better bounce in his step, a lot better leadership. Had guys after the game that evening thought he was the best player during halftime, during the second half, and after the game. Which was good to see because I thought earlier he looked a little tired, looked a little sluggish, still playing okay, but just from some of the things he gives us off the field. So I was really proud of Timmy. We recognized him as our player of the game defensively and really just great to see some of his attitude at a high, high level. It was great to see. Scout offense, we honored Wes Martin, an offensive lineman. It's doing a nice job for us. And on Scout D, we recognized Noel Padmore, who travels, plays a little bit, but because second and third team guys don't get a lot of work, he gets a lot of work on our scout look, and he had a great week for us, and we appreciate that. In the kicking game, Maryland came in number two in the country in overall kick unit. We, for the most part, held our own in a lot of ways, very, very pleased with our effort there. Our punt team was good. We let one get out a little bit, but our punter did a great job, Eric, in punting. Our coverage was solid. Punt return, we had a big one called back, but a little bit better in the return game. It was good to see. Kickoff return, had the best returns we've had to date in KOR. Kickoff coverage was solid. Our players at game special team were Griffin Oates and Eric Toth, both of them again. And I think Griff was honored as the Big Ten special team player of the week. Had a nice long kick. Like we told you guys, those guys were good from 57-ish, I think we said. It was 58. Thought he had a shot. Wim wasn't hurting him, so nice kick. I didn't like the halftime celebration like it was over. If we didn't think we could have made that kick, we got a first down, and on second down, we had an incomplete pass. First down on second 10, we ran an option play trying to get to the perimeter, and we didn't make a block inside. A linebacker made a play, so third and 10, we didn't want to give them back. We kind of milked the clock a little. Didn't make a third down play, but they got a penalty. The score had gotten to 20 to, I think the score was 20 to 6, and they had scored two or three times in a row. So we didn't want to go in without momentum to come back and make a couple plays. Matter of fact, we're very lucky. Nate really threw a check down pass that if Stoner catches, the half's over. And we're kind of lucky he didn't catch it. And we were trying, it was kind of tough. They were bracketing outside. They weren't giving you sideline throws. We were out of timeout. So it was nice to see Griff make that kick. He's been awesome kickoffs. We've got a lot of touchbacks. He was 3 of 4. We needed to make them all. He missed the 54-yarder. At the same time, he's got short-term success. And like a lot of people around here, we seem not to handle that real good. So not surprised. I still think Del Grosso has been through practice as consistent or more. So hopefully we'll start having some competition there. Those guys will keep pushing themselves. And as we move forward, those guys will be fine. Those are the two best kids in our state a couple years ago. So they'll do fine for us. North Texas is coming in. They're 2-2. Moving on those guys. Again, disappointed with last week's play. But not our kids and what we're doing. We'll keep this thing moving. North Texas coming in 2-2. Bowl team a year ago, 9 wins, bowl victory a year ago. Have played this year at Texas, last year at Georgia. They played, you know, some quality teams year after year. They won't be impressed walking in here with us or this arena if they're not used to being in it. A lot of those kids, you know, coming out of the Texas, I think they've got the most kids on any team in the country from the state of Texas, which is great football. Their kids play fast, very athletic and active. They play very, very hard. Very physical. They're well coached. Got a new quarterback playing for him, Dejon Williams, who came in the last. They got Louisiana Tech a Thursday night game 2.5 weeks ago. Played well and got up 42-0 or 7 on them. And Williams came in and played the fourth quarter. And since then, played one game. They've had an open date. Since he's played, his rating at quarterback is 232. He's 16-21 for 3 touchdowns, 0 interceptions, and they have scored 98 points in 5 quarters. And for the year, they've scored, what's their number for the year? 148. So they've scored 50 in the rest of their games. He's got them rolling. So very impressed with him. A little bit different attack with run pass threats, different, but similar to what we saw last week with Maryland's quarterbacks. So really playing some unique offense. And coming into an open date, they've got an open date this week, so they got 2 weeks to get prepared for us. Their defense, very, very aggressive, attacking defense, very, very physical. Well, they're giving up right at 80 yards a game, rush defense, one of the best in the country. Always a style of Coach Sklodany and their D coordinator, and Coach McCarney, who's the defensive coach. I think every player in their 2-deep has a sack. We've got 7 sacks for the year. They've got about 18, I think it is, 17 or 18. Very good in turnovers. So against the Coach McCarney team, I know we had the opportunity to play them a couple years ago. And when I looked at the scoreboard, it was 24-0 them, and we were getting our butts waxed. So, again, a lot of respect for their team. It'll be a tough challenge. Expect our guys to have a good week. Expect us to play hard. We'll look forward to a great game Saturday at 2:30 with these guys.
You mentioned their run defense. In particular, what makes them so effective? And then when teams load the box on you, how hard is it for you to get the run game going when they're obviously trying to shut down the run?
Well, most people are going to start, you know, by trying to what their mathematical numbers are and schemes are to get the box loaded, whether it be by pressure or edge backer and safety alignments or corner support structures, whatever, to quote, get those extra hats. And that's where every defense tries to start every week. They have great eye discipline, where when you do that, your players that are responsible for covering receivers need to keep your eyes on your receiver, because we're going to cheat and put halfway backers and safeties committed to run. That being said, if you're responsible for a receiver, you make sure he doesn't beat you, so they don't give up a lot of big plays to commit to the run, which is a sign of a really good defense. It's a 4-3 structure. They pick their spots how they want to pressure out of it, but it's just a very, very – I think their best defensive end is about 230 pounds, but he is active and plays hard. It's the type of program that Coach McCarney's always had. I think he was the winningest coach in Iowa State history, or one of them. So he's coached a number of years, very, very successful. His guys are going to play hard, and Coach Sklodany, Jim's been a lot of places, great defensive coach. They got its structure, its attitude, you know, some quick guys. But again, when the box gets loaded, you got to make one-on-one plays. They got some guys that play good one-on-one defense. They've got 4 guys off their defense a year ago in pro camps. We got some active guys, good football team.
You mentioned the,
I think there's a guy playing for the Cowboys last night. This is a North Texas guy we played against a couple years ago. So, I mean, they got some really good football players now. Trust me.
You mentioned the return getting called back as a penalty. Evans, long run, touchdown run called back with a penalty. Is this team at a point where it's mentally strong enough to bounce back from losing those two scores, just the emotions of getting up and then seeing that flag?
Well, you got to be, because you're not going to get everything go, and not everything's going to go your way. Whether we call a foolish play, or you make an error, you drop a pass, or you miss a tackle, or you miss a call, or there's a bunch of humans out there, you know, on game day doing a lot of things, and human error, it's not going to be a game of perfect. So we've told, and what's been pleasing is that we think our guys realize that things aren't going to go our way and you can overcome them. You know, we had two penalties, was what it was, still had the opportunity to score. You know, afterwards, I think one of them, we got a field goal out of one of them, I think. So, you know, you just kind of keep playing. You know, we talked about a week ago, you know, we jump off sides on a kick play and our freshman kicks it again. We get a late hit on the quarterback, and that same guy made the tackle to win the game. So I think, you know, we've talked, but again, you got to do it. And, you know, there was a lot of reasons the other day, but more importantly, we just, you know, we got our butt beat, and more than, hey, that one play let us down. I mean, there was not that, we didn't lose that game because of a play getting called back. We got outplayed.
Did you have a sense before the game that
anything weren't where they were? No. We didn't deviate one thing. Afterwards, the guys started like, hey, I didn't think, you know, again, hopefully these guys will get to the point. And it's obvious, if you just look at the games last week across the country. Look at the week before. I mean, if you don't come to play, there's such a fine line between a play or two, a call or two, and your ability to play hard, that if you're not on, I don't care who you are. And that, to me, is what we said a week ago. That's what separates the really strong players and really strong teams from the guys that aren't, is consistency. It's not, hey, they got a bunch more better recruits and more tradition. No, they do it week after week after week. As we build, we said that back in preseason. What do you want? We want competition and we want consistency. And we're still going to keep pushing for that. Because to me, that's what really good. That creates the trust we talked about a week ago. And trust with fans. Hey, you got to consistently play. We didn't do it. Now, again, we didn't change, quote, our practice routine. But for whatever in our thought process, we were not the same team. Disappointing. See if we can learn from it. I don't think some rah-rah talk to – I mean, we're going to maintain – I truly believe we've been doing a lot of things right in our structure. We're going to keep doing this. We didn't come in yesterday and start yelling at them. We didn't show a bunch of negative. Hey, here's some good plays. Week before, hey, here's some good plays. Here's some bad plays. Hey, here it is on tape again. This is your effort. Do you like this picture? Because that is you. Don't sit here and say that's not us, because that was us. And that's how we play when we're not on. And now let's get back on, because we've been on against pretty good teams, and we've been off. We got to consistently find ways to keep staying on. And that's my job, to create that and foster that.
Could you detect, after watching the film, any specifics into why the passing game struggled so much?
No, I didn't like some of the just, you know, our concepts and what we were doing. They loaded the box up. The pocket got collapsed a lot. You know, we kind of got walked, even some plays where, and not some plays, even he scrambled, just there wasn't some clean places for him to throw where protection's clean and firm so you can step into some throws where you have muddy water coming at you versus it's firm and I can stand there and play. Some receiving timing's got to get up. We had some guys open we missed. We missed some throws. We had some protection. It was a combination of all, from protection to route running to concepts to everything. It was errors by the entire group, from the schemes and play calling. I mean, it could all be better. Got guys open, we missed too, though. Several drops. I mean, you name it. I mean, it was a day where if anyone had a part of passing could mess up some things, we were hitting on about 10 all day, whether it be the play call, the time to call it, the protection, the route, the ball placement, the read, the drop, the catch, whatever. You name it, we were all a part of it collectively.
How much has it been the Nate and kind of a largely either new group of receivers or receivers in new roles that's been kind of hard to make that click, or is that as much to do with it as what you just described?
You can say that, but that's an excuse. I mean, I'm watching A&M and they got a new QB and a bunch of guys got drafted and those next guys came in, they're ready to play, and our guys got to come in. Well, you're in college, you're gonna lose some guys now. You're gonna have an injury you don't want, or I mean, things happen. Next guy up, you got to do it. You know, we're not going to change. At the same time, I think we've shown the last couple weeks before that, when you throw for 300-something and 200-something, it's a really good team on the road. It's not bad. We just, you know, we got to do a better job maybe scheming it up. They did a nice job of and again, which they're going to. You know, if they take away the run, balance to me is when they take the run away, you can execute it. We had 37 pass calls. We did it. We didn't execute it enough. And so, again, we'll look at what we're calling. It just got to be sharp, and we'll keep pushing for it. I'm pretty confident it's going to be there, but but it's got to be consistent, because you go back the previous 2 weeks, you see some pretty good things. And then all of a sudden you see that one, you've got two really not good passing days and two pretty solid passing days. And the two solid days are against, you know, decent teams too. So, hey, what is it? But again, credit Maryland, they played well. We still had some guys open. But, you know, when protection, run game, staying on schedule, schematics, set your feet, rip it, don't aim it, rip it, be aggressive, trust it. We'll keep pushing. We won't change. We got to get better, though. I mean, you're on the right. We got to get better at it. And I believe we will. I'm sure we will.
Has there been any thought in switching things up to Shane and moving him back to the goal role?
I mean, you know, he was in the slot the other day. You know, missed him on a corner route. So, I mean, if you don't block him, you know, stay on schedule. You don't throw everything to him. You got to throw it to a bunch of guys. They can always take away one guy wherever he is. So, and they ain't taking him away. They're not honoring him. They're not respecting him. They're not respecting the pass game. They're stopping the run. So, and if you want to work one guy, you can always defend one guy. Our offense has been about not one guy. Then right now we got the run game going pretty good, and the pass game's been a little inconsistent. Run game really wasn't as consistent the other day too. A couple long runs skewed those numbers stat-wise to make it look a little bit better. So, to me, it's not about one guy. And the other guy's playing pretty good inside. He's doing okay outside. You know, we'll keep looking at him. I don't think that's the answer. I don't think that's the problem. I mean, I think it's a team problem. From schematics, coaching, play calling to team execution. When you're doing something good, the team's doing – I mean, when we're running the ball good, them receivers are part of that too now. I mean, it's all – when you're doing something good, it's a team deal. When you're just struggling, typically it's a team deal. And collectively, I say across the board, we were way off field. And I hadn't practiced that way, but we'll see. Again, more than anything, when you get out of rhythm, get out of whack, hard to get it going. We didn't jump start it. We just let them off the hook. We'll see what we can do this week. Because this week will be loaded boxes. This week will be some one-on-ones. They're very, very competitive, very, very good in the secondary. It's going to be a tough week. Saying like this is going to be an easy week to, quote, solve our problems, because they're a very, very good defense.
As an offensive guy, when you see the offense struggling and admitting on things, does that just make you nuts on the sideline? Do you see that and just
make you nuts? No, I mean, you know, I'm always like, hey, what's the answers? Because to me, the field's way too big. That's why I think the hardest thing going, and we're playing somebody like the team coming in or the team that we just played that played good defense, you got to give them a lot of credit, because it's really hard to. There's a lot of space. There's a lot of grass. There's a lot of good players, and offenses have gotten to where they're making you defend a lot. And to me, it's like, hey, finding answers. Okay, if they're doing this, let's get to this. And that's, you know, it's one of the reasons why I kind of try to stand behind the defense if I can. I'm kind of looking at them. I'm not watching us. Where are they at? Where do we need to go? What are they doing? You know, so I just, you know, I get more into trying to problem solve and getting frustrated. Now afterwards, then you go back, okay, now what did we really do? Did we really do something different in practice? Should we practice things more? Are we doing it with the right guys in the right spot? Hey, let's eval. We're not going to stay stubborn. I mean, I think we've always evolved, and we have to continue. We always will.
One of Maryland's linebackers said after the game that they were sort of picking up on some of your calls, I guess maybe the ways you guys were lining up on offense. Did you see anything on film that maybe you guys were revealing stuff?
I mean, we kind of do what we do. I mean, I was calling their option when it was option and screen from the sideline too, and here comes their screen and bubble. I mean, you know, you kind of watch guys, you get a feel for what guys do. You know, I mean, so. And we have tendencies. Every team does. You still have to execute. If you don't win the line of scrimmage or play hard, odds go down a little. If they're on to something, again, we always do our self-scouts. We'll keep looking at it. We were different. There were new things we did Saturday we hadn't done. Some new routes. Some of them didn't work. But anyway, you know, when you have success, you got all the answers. Like I said, we didn't think we had any. So I don't know. I mean, you should stand by me on the sideline when the other team. I call about 70% of the plays right, watching your offense. Same side power. Here it comes. Screen. Here. I mean, now kids can't hear you. You know, that's why your voice is raspy. It's wasted, like you guys yelling at the TV when you don't travel. It's like, hey, can't nobody hear you, right? But you get a feel for stuff. But that's the beauty. It still comes down to execution. I mean, most time, you know what? We can sit there. Right now, we're going to spend a bunch of hours this week watching North Texas do what they do, and they're going to do what they do. And they do it really good. Why are you wearing the green shirt today anyway? We'll see. I mean, he came off. He's got like a sprained knee deal, and we'll see how he goes this week and what's the strength level and tolerance. You know, during the game, because it was loose, he was clear to come back, and we said no. Now that you've had a couple of days off, and we get back to practicing, you know, what really is the range of motion? What's the strength level? We're not going to put him in a bad position if he can't go. And we're lucky that Demetri Camille started, Peyton Eckert started for a couple of years, so we got some depth there. So if we need it, we'll move forward. I guess it'll be a day-to-day deal. And since we, you know, yesterday's the light day, today's off, we'll know more as the week goes. So I guess it's a wait-and-see deal. Outside of that, we're exactly where we're health-wise as far as no limitations. Murphy didn't play with a slight ham. Saw him today. He'll probably do more, and we'll see if he's back in the mix. Thought Chase Dutcher and Keontae Walton did okay in his spot anyway, so we'll get Murph back.
You mentioned Maryland screens. They were able to beat you a couple times on it. What was the, I guess, the lack of recognition from somebody?
Well, I mean, now some of it's pretty good now. Crack screen, one that we do a lot, and we score on once in a while. They had one on their sideline. A couple of them were some play action screens where, you know, the demeanor of the quarterback, yeah, I got my back to it, and everybody starts running one way, he aborts and comes back. One time they did it off an option. Hey, we're going option this way, and I'm going to stop and throw back. So some of it's almost like a little bit of a counter deal. And they were a good screen team. I mean, they threw it deep. They threw it short. The team we play this week is going to do the same thing. They're going to take their shots and throw it underneath. So their version of the same deal. But, again, that's the essence to me of good offense. They're making you defend the field in every one. And just good play calling, good execution. Some things we need to do better. Well, we always call it the long foul ball. You know, everybody gets like all excited, you know, and then there's a gasp of air because we're at the end, nothing happened. And the defense never feels, even when you beat them, the defense never feels threatened until you make the play. And at the same time, we got to be smart and calculated in that. We need to make sure when we are taking shots, the one interception we had the other day, Nate actually adjusted a route he didn't need to. I'm like, why'd you do it? And he says, man, I said, but, you know, we had an in-breaking route and was the guy inside or outside. I thought you had the in-breaker. And he got stuck because he wanted to throw one to Shane. He wanted to throw a deep one. I said, hey, you got haunted. So my deal is we actually looked at with him last week, and sometimes it's timing. Sometimes we call it deep routes. They're not deep routes. They're get open routes. So if you can't win, you have options of stopping it, coming back, or bending. So you're just not running. And sometimes I think we're running just to run. And there's some what you're doing is it's no different than, you know, when you're, you know, in the basketball world and they're playing a 2-3 zone, you're finding spaces within the zone to get open. Well, it's the same thing on certain routes. I mean, we've got a deep route, but he has options to get – he has options, and he also has options relative to the defensive line because he has to beat the defensive end, not the corner. So can I beat him deep, beat him short? What am I doing? But I got to beat him before the end gets there. So I got about 2.4, 2.5 to side, and the ball's – and quarterback's got to know, and that's when we talk about timing. Hey, right now, is he going by him? Is he snapping it off? Is he coming back? You know, I mean, there's a lot of things. Is he taking it over the top of the guy, or is he going inside? And it takes time with that. And if we go out there and practice it over and over and over, we'll get a lot better, but we'll also get a lot tired. So it's limited reps. I mean, so you don't want to run like 60 go balls. And a kid like, you know, Shane or somebody, Nick's going to be gassed. So there's spots. So that's when we talk about timing. That's some of the timing. And the teams that are really, really good, when you watch them, they're just doing things where they're so in sync where those guys know, hey, I got you. I'm dropping. The quarterback knows. And those are things right now we're just kind of working on. We're not near as good as it ought to be. And we got to fight to get that because those pictures change all the time. And like I say, and it's always neat. I get the running back on Sunday 20 times and tell them what they want to do. He's got about 1.7 or 1.8 seconds to figure it out, or he's really good or really bad. I get the running back for 30 seconds and say, well, why didn't you do this? And how about that? And he's got to see it right now. And the receiver's the same deal. And that's what being in sync is about. They got about 2 seconds to figure it out because coverage is adjusted. That's why it's pretty neat and it's pretty challenging. It's a lot of fun. Anything else?
This is the second time in the season you guys prepared for a team with one of their former coaches on your staff, Larry Bowling Green, you know, with North Texas. How much do you rely on those guys during the week to give them that voice?
You know, we didn't a whole lot. Matter of fact, I even said something to Nate because Nate's a very smart guy. I go, don't be talking to Coach Joseph about all their DBs that he coached because he'll give you too much info. And now you're about to think, oh, by the way, this guy's – I go, you know, because you got 1.7 seconds. You don't need clutter in your mind. So, I mean, bottom line, it's a defensive structure that's very sound, that's been going around for a long time, that their coaches that we've went against do and you know, and they coach it well. And We didn't spend a whole lot of time with Coach McDaniel going into Bowling Green. It's more about their tape and their players this year. So I didn't get into, you know, the games about those guys. I mean, I guess you can. I don't know. I get more into watching tape and what I see on tape more than what guys think about them. Because I think sometimes I think the more you know, sometimes it can almost hurt you. So, like, you know, I don't need to know this guy can do that. I'm just watching tape, and I see this, and this is how we want to attack. Don't overload me here. So I don't think it's a big deal. Glad he's here. Anything else? That was good. Get a new shirt.